Okay, hey everybody, we're going to talk today about how to use the database CINAHL. And CINAHL, as you may know, is an EBSCO database, but unlike Academic Search Premier or some of the other EBSCO databases, this is specifically for nursing articles. So this is looking at articles from nursing journals. If you're in a nursing class, it's very likely you've been asked to use CINAHL. It's spelled kind of strange, C-I-N-A-H-L. And so it's a comprehensive index to nursing and allied health literature. I'm very impressed I remembered that. Anyway, it works like a regular database where it's going to search for, but it's only going to be pulling from nursing and medical journals. So I'm just going to run a search here for articles on diabetes. Now we have 21,340 in here. We could make that more specific. A few things we could do here. We could do select a field. We could set that to title. Only bring me back articles with diabetes in the title. Doing a search here, that took it down to 10,699. And one thing I would do here, it's coming by relevance. I'm going to set this by date newest. I want to see the newest ones first so I can be up to date on the latest research. Okay. Now, a lot of these, probably most of these are already going to be peer reviewed in here since it's kind of pulling from peer reviewed journals. That's going to just raise up the research level so it's from a more academic or like a medical type journal. I'm going to click here peer-reviewed just for the heck of it. Your instructor may have asked you for peer-reviewed articles. That's a nice thing about this database. If you click here, so it took about 1,000 of those out of them, but most of them were already peer-reviewed. So let's say I want to make this more specific. Well, how about in this next box I type 2 or type 2. It's probably going to be in there with the numeral. But I spelled it out too. This, since it's kind of a trick, you can do or, so I get this or that, depending on how it's in there. I put the type 2, I want that phrase exactly, so I put it in quotation marks, same with it spelled out. So we're still going to have diabetes in the title, still going to be peer-reviewed, and also another thing, always leave this full text button on. That'll bring you the full articles. You don't want to just get abstracts and citations. We do a search. Okay, now we're down to 4,182. We notice that there's still diabetes in all of them, but type 2 or type 2 is in there somewhere. What if we raise it up and say type 2 has to be in the title as well? And then we have 2,606. Okay, so we're looking pretty good. You could also, if you wanted to, maybe make this more specific. Maybe if you put in exercise or fitness or something like that, or that's a good suggestion. Physical activity. So let's search there. And you can just keep making it more and more specific. So now there's 322. Now you probably know what I'm going to do next. I usually go to title. It just makes it more specific. You could also put it in the subject or any of those. That's just a really, really, really specific way to search. Now we're down to 91. And you notice now, okay, physical fitness is in there. Now that's pretty good. Physical function, people with type 2 diabetes. Okay, now we got exercise in there. They're all looking pretty specific to what we're looking for. If you click on one of these articles, and it comes up first with the abstract, and you're probably wondering, well, where's the full article? This tells you all about the article. If you want to get the full article, click the PDF full text button, and then it loads the full article for you. You could print that out right here. You could email it to yourself, which is kind of nice. Or you could do this here. You could download it, print it here, and there's the full article. I'm going to go back to the detailed record, which is that abstract they originally gave us. Also, something that's really nice is I'm not going to show you really in too much detail how to do this here because I have a second video that shows you how to do this, but what about citations? Right here is a nice little citation assistant. It does make a few mistakes, so just be careful, but I clicked there. And then I'm looking for APA. Most medical classes or nursing classes are going to ask for APA. So I'm just going to copy this. I'm going to highlight it and copy it. I'm going to go into my Word document. This is the last page of my paper, which is going to say references to show what I used. I'm going to paste this in. Now notice it looks a little weird when it comes in here. What you want to do is go here on this little clipboard and merge formatting to take all that weird stuff off. There still needs to be a few things fixed. We're going to go here, go to paragraph, highlight everything, go to paragraph. We're going to set this to a special indent called a hanging indent. Notice how it indented the second, third lines over. We're going to make it double spaced. And then if it's not on, I would suggest don't add extra space between paragraphs. Click that little button. And then we're starting to have a nice looking citation. Now you know with MLA, only the first Only the first word of the titles get capitalized. So is that probably don't need that there. Just go through here, and I can do a little trick here and highlight all these letters that do not need to be capitalized. The APA, oddly enough, it looks a little strange if you're used to MLA, but unless we're dealing with proper nouns or names, or unless it's a subtitle, they don't need all those letters capitalized. So I'm going to do a little trick here. Shift F3, that took them, that's kind of neat, isn't it? Shift F3 brings it between uppercase and lowercase with all those. Now after the subtitle, we are going to start the capitalization again, but then it goes back to not being capitalized. Okay, Shift F3. I cover this more in depth in the other video, but there's a pretty nice citation. Goes pretty quickly. If we go down here, if we go back to the list, let's go back to the result list. Let's go to this second article. Let's do the citation again. I said I wasn't going to go into too much detail, but here I am. That's okay. It doesn't take very long. Going to go down to APA. The thing that's nice, this, the next time you grab a citation and you drop it in, it does a lot for you since we've already done it once. We do this here. Now when we say merge formatting, that middle button there, see how it copied most of the format onto here. And so now that needs to be capitalized because it's the subtitle after the colon there. But it's looking pretty good. It's a pretty quick way to get your citations in here. Okay, let's minimize that and go back to our thing here. And also from the citation, you could email the citation to yourself too. This is a nice tool. You click email here, just type in your email address there and it will email you this article. Okay, let's go back to let's do a new search here. Another thing that's kind of nice there, we're looking for articles. This is kind of cool, evidence-based care sheets. These are if you're looking for the basics of a certain thing. Let's go in here to diabetes. The articles are great, but they're super, super, super specific. We're looking at diabetes, and specifically we were looking at exercise there. So if I click here, I see that diabetes type 2 effective exercise. That's exactly what I was looking at. If I do a search now, it's going to bring me back this nice evidence-based care sheet, which is kind of like the basics of what we know about this. It's not going to be as specific as an article. It's just going to just sum up all the basics of what we know about this disorder and what does exercise do. This would be good maybe to work with a patient to get to sum up, or for yourself to quickly get up to speed on a certain issue. Notice it's a lot shorter, but this is really useful in nursing. Let's go back to the result list and let's go back to just anytime you want to start over, just do a new search. And you'll just notice through here, there's all sorts of different limits you could place on this. Clinical queries, but there's just all sorts of things you could set on here. Journal subset, where do you want the journals to come from? What types of journals? Publication type. And another thing that's nice, you could even set the age group. So let's say we were looking for preschool, 2 to 5 years. So we're only going to look for that now. And let's do another search similar to what we just did here before. Now we already know, let's just go diabetes title and say 2 or 2 in the title. Now this time I don't know what we're going to get, but we're just searching in the preschool years. See if we get anything. Okay, so we got 27 articles, much less, but that's because we're just looking for things with these in the title, kind of like before. And we're just looking for, and you notice there, these are about kids now. So we're looking, if you're searching for that kind of a specific thing for preschool age children, that's just really a home run for you right there. So this concludes my video on CINAHL. This is an intro to it. If you have any questions on this, please stop by the library or call us or email us, and we will be glad to help you further with this. Thanks for watching.